In one of our previous videos, we discussed arrangement of resistors. Today we are going to discuss arrangement of cells. Just like resistors, cells can also be arranged in two ways. They can either be arranged in series or in parallel. In one of our previous videos, there are some things we said that when resistors are arranged in series like this, if we want to find the effective potential difference between this end and that end, we are supposed to add the potential difference across resistor 1 plus the potential difference across resistor 2 plus the potential difference across resistor 3, which is V1, V2, V3. The current is the same, but if you want to get the effective, the total PD, we add all the three. That is for resistors in series. If we have resistors that are in parallel, we are supposed to, for potential differences for resistors in parallel, the potential difference is the same across all resistors, whether the resistors are identical or they have different resistances. The PD across here is the same, but the current that is going through here is not the same. Some of it is the current coming in here is split into three. If these resistors are identical, it will mean it's the same current that is split throughout these three, and so on. This is a cell, that is a cell, and that is a cell. Collectively, they make a battery. So if you want to find the effective EMF or the total EMF of this battery, it means we are supposed to add the EMF of that cell and the EMF of that cell and the EMF of that cell. That is how we get the effective EMF. Each of these cells has got an internal resistance. But since these internal resistances are in series, just like the way we did with resistors in series, we shall simply add the resistors like that, and we get the effective internal resistance of the cell. For cells in parallel, we shall do just like before. For cells in parallel, the potential difference or the EMF between across all these is the same for cells in parallel. So it means that E1 will be equal to E2, will be equal to E3. And if you want to find the effective resistance of this combination, we take it as though they are resistances that are in parallel. And the formula we derived before will be the one at work. That brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like and share this video, and for more videos, please subscribe. Please like our Facebook page at Kisembo Academy Video Tutorials, or follow us on Twitter at Kisembo Academy. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Rangakuramia.